Welcome in to this special bonus edition of the Half Price Concessions podcast. Today's episode won't sound like any other episode you've heard from us. Today's topic is Christmas. No list or ranking of Christmas activities, no discussion about all the things that typically go along with Christmas celebrations like standing under the mistletoe or things like that. Those are all fine and dandy, and I partake in plenty of them myself, but I feel a strong need to just share a part of the story from the Bible that is literally the whole reason for Christmas, the birth of Jesus. All the other stuff that you and I enjoy is all basically extra. The gift giving, the decorations, the movies, the outfits, ugly sweaters we wear, the Santa stuff, all of that pales in comparison to what Christmas is truly all about. And to help keep that in perspective, here is a piece of the Christmas story as read from the Bible. Before the birth of Jesus even takes place in the New Testament, it is actually foretold or prophesied in the Old Testament. Isaiah chapter 7 verse 14 says, "Therefore the Lord himself shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel." Emmanuel meaning God with us. There's more verses in the Old Testament that hint at or prophesy about the coming of Jesus, but for now, we'll get on to his story. For that, we go to the Gospel according to Luke. Chapter 1, verse 26 is where we start. "And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee, named Nazareth, to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail, thou that art highly favored, the Lord is with thee, blessed art thou among women. And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and bring forth a son, and shalt call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David, and he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end. Then Mary said unto the angel, How shall this be, seeing I know not a man? And the angel answered and said unto her, The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God." Mary responds to this in a few verses later in chapter 1 verse 38. "And Mary said, Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to thy word. And the angel departed from her." Now from there, before we get into the next chapter of Luke, we'll head over to Matthew chapter 1 verse 18. I take you to this part so that you can hear Joseph's side. Joseph, who was the man that Mary was engaged to marry, that's who she was betrothed to. This is Joseph's side. Mary had her encounter with an angel of God. Now you'll hear Joseph's side. This is Matthew chapter 1, verse 18, where we pick up. "Now the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise. When as his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Ghost. Then Joseph her husband, being a just man and not wanting to make her a public example, was minded to put her away privately. But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Now all this was done, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us. Then Joseph, being raised from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord had bidden him, and took unto him his wife, and knew her not till she had brought forth her firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus. So you can see in that scripture, Mary's first encounter with the angel of the Lord, and you see also Joseph's encounter with an angel of the Lord. Now we go on to Luke chapter 2. There's a few things that are actually going on intertwined in this story. I left out a few verses to try to just keep your focus on Jesus, but definitely encourage you to go back and read it yourself. There's verses in there that talk about John the Baptist, who would be the forerunner for Jesus, and all kinds of good stuff, but I just want to try to keep this simple for this recording. In Luke chapter 2 we go, And it came unto pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius, the governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, every one unto his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them. And they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God, saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem, and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste, and found Mary, and Joseph, and babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they had made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all they had heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all those things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, as it was told unto them. And when 8 days were accomplished for the circumcising of the child, his name was called Jesus, which was so named of the angel before he was conceived in the womb. Now, if you're wondering where the wise men come from in your nativity scene, that's in Matthew chapter 2. But for the sake of simplicity, I'll leave it out here. But I definitely encourage you to go check it out for yourself, just so that you can learn why all those people are at the nativity scene. But this, at its most basic, is the story of why we as Christians celebrate Christmas, the birth of Jesus, the visible image of the invisible God, the fulfillment of the prophecy, the author of our salvation, the moment when God sent his son to be born of a virgin who would eventually sacrifice himself so that we may through him have eternal life. This is Christmas. Thank you for listening, and I hope that you and your family and friends have a Merry Christmas indeed. God bless.